Welcome to Heronsgate. Heronsgate was the first estate to be bought by the land company. And there it is, that's the plan. They are all telling you all about the different buildings on the site. That's Feargus O'Connor's signature. Feargus O'Connor, it was his vision to do the Chartist Land Company. And in pursuit of his social ideas, Feargus O'Connor wanted workers to be able to vote for their choice of candidate for Parliament. And to qualify, they had to own a property. Now, workers were to be given the chance to enter a lottery. Life on the land, in your cottage, on your small holding, was presented as a life of freedom. And the plan was that £5,000 should be raised from 2,000 shares costing £2.10 or £2.50 each. Now, this money would be used to buy land. 103 acres were purchased, and to self-build 60 cottages and to buy stock. To enter the lottery, workers had to buy shares. This could be done in weekly instalments of 3D. And the original plan was that the winners would own their freehold, but because of the legal difficulties, that did not happen. And fee farm rent, a medieval term for rent of agricultural land, was payable by the winners on their 2, 3 or 4 acre plots. As an alternative to rent, a capital sum could be paid, but no one took up this option, and in most cases, after the land company was wound up, freeholds were acquired, but in a few cases, this rent was still paid until recently. Now, there's Feargus O'Connor, as you can see, and many of you have seen this before in the museum. This is from the London Journal, and I don't know if any of you can see it from there. We're going to the school on our first port of call, but that's where we are now. And that, there was a Chartist cottage on this land, and it was a single storey one, and on this plan here, you're here now. So we should go next door and go down here. And these are various little souvenir things that were made to celebrate the opening of the estate in 1846 of Old Connerville. That's actually the, if you want to pass that round, that is the actual school, so that you can compare the building as it was. That was the type of building we had on this land, but there was a fire and we think it just became derelict.
There was a school somewhere, wasn't there, a private school?
Yes,
it was.
I used to go next door. Yes, Beaumont House. That's Beaumont House, right at the bottom. Going back to the dwellings, there are they consisted of two-storey cottages, and we'll see some on our way down Heronsgate, and single-storey cottages, that sort of thing, you know. But obviously most of them have changed, but if you see on that picture, you'll see how they were at that time. Working on the land, so a lot of people just, it was a good life, you know. Mm-hmm. Anne Dawson, a little girl that went to the school. We don't know who she is. It was 1847, but we've not been able to trace. Yeah. Well, the Chartist movement, there's a big book, and I mean, it's just reams of it. This 1837 to 1854, and really that is all about Parliament. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
A
1846, when the estate was opened, built for the Chartist children. That was the girls' section, and behind there is an arch where the boys entered. But it was like that at the other side. It was also the Chartist children could go, although there's no record of them at all as being, you know, pupils here. Now the school charges were 16 guineas per annum, and
amazing.
And they were provided with stationery, and you know, they had their board for that price. By 1851, the school closed and it became a private house, and it was called Heronsgate House. So that's about as much as we know about the school, really, except that the Chartists in May 1847, they came here and they celebrated the opening of O'Connor. So they had a party here, and Feargus O'Connor was preaching to various dignitaries from Rickmansworth and Chorleywood in the house. And then they escorted all the allottees down to the various cottages to separate.
And your mother
bringing revenue. Oh, the lanes of Heronsgate, Bradford. Are they? There's one of three post offices here. And there you are.
Yeah,
and she would have stood sort of here.
Yeah, yeah.
In the window.
Oh, lovely.
The Wesleyan Chapel built in 1884. There's quite a number of Wesleyans in Heronsgate, and it became, when John Wesley brought the movement into being, it became much more popular to, and they started building chapels. And John Proctor of Woodoaks built this. He organised this to be built. In fact, it's Finley's farm down at Maple Cross. It fell into decline and it wasn't used very much. The Heronsgate Residents Association bought it, and we now use it as our
village hall.
Yeah, village hall, yes. But we use it, and it's great inside. It's really, I'd like to show you inside. It's beautiful. It's all shiplacked inside. Very oldy worldy. And we had it here. This is the first post office, and they called the house Old Connor, and that was in 1902. This was the first post office, and that window there was, it was a general stores and post office, additions at the back. And there's the sign again, and this is the two semis together. But there's obviously been.
It is a bit, yes. I mean, I don't know what to do. Sort of bring it. I'll turn around one corner. This is St. John's.
The church was built in 1875. Prior to that, before the chancel was added, this was a church. It was a mission hall, and the children from the school used to use it. That's it. Minister, and that window there was commemorated to him.
barricaded that room with those three windows to him. Yes, it was usually sometimes half a dozen of you. Because it is Swillett and Maple Cross. But we hang all candlelight, put those out, and there are about 80 candles all going around the harbour. And it's just candlelit. It is a lovely shadows. Yes. And we have
Harry Esperanti.
Yes, Kim Philby, the spy. Mm-hmm. And he was living in Heronsgate in 1956, and the police cars came down here, screeching their sirens and everything. He wasn't at home.
Like Dallas, isn't it?
Yes. Yes. Just racing.
One in original condition, I should think. Estate agent's green.
So the old part of the house is up to here. Original cookie chimney.
Yes.
If you've got your official Heronsgate Rittlesworth guide, it's actually a photo of this in there.
Difficult for little boys going up, really.
Sorry?
Difficult for little boys going up. I love this.
It was a 2-acre plot in the field that I don't know if you're going through it. It was all down.
Yeah.
And they said it was made up north about 1840, so it could well be original. Yeah. The door. This is 1974 when we bought it. That's the outside. I was born in Heronsgate and lived in London. Saw it in sitting outside an antique shop. So we got a photo done of it. Absolutely wonderful poem about O'Connor and Britannia, the land where fell slavery's chain. That's quite interesting. But there was no harp or anything.
Yes.
And then this was behind the plaster and we left it open. So there's the occasional bit of wood, which I think is what they did.
This isn't original, this we did when we came, that dress, sort of in keeping. You know, metal and very jazzy, so each one was different. Tongue and groove wall again here, up the stairs. Oh, and nice. When the National Trust came to look at my dresser, they looked at the doors and were very interested in the way the doors and the top were all done together, rather than make a doorway and fit a door. They just did the whole thing, and the same is upstairs.
You wouldn't have to be in a hurry, would you?
Yes, you go first. Gosh, could you get that book on the top shelf? Yeah. It's so pretty.
This is all
not
new, isn't
it?
This is new.
She's
actually
the
side.
Yeah. So we built on this bit, and instead of building on a bathroom,
and the
board,
isn't it?
We built it
later
in the house.
Yeah. This is Jane, my youngest. Yes.
Interesting.
They do grow up.
They do go. Yeah. On your way.